In this video, we'll see how to make a box plot and find the 5-number summary for a simple data set. So go ahead and grab your TI-83 or 84 right now. The instructions for both calculators are identical. And let's enter this data set here. So we'll go to Stat, Edit to get to our lists, and we'll enter the data. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 8, 12. Now that the data is entered, we can make a box plot or a statistical plot by going to second y equals, and then we'll want to turn plot 1 on, make sure it's on, choose the graph of interest, which in this case is a box plot, and then we're going to zoom and choose zoom 9 to get a good window. So let's see what this looks like. You're probably used to going to y equals in other math classes. Here you can draw functions, but we're going to go to second y equals, and this is stat plot. So second y equals is stat plot. We can hit 1 or enter to select plot 1. And right now we can see that it's off, so we'll hit enter again. And now you can see that on is selected. Now hit the down arrow, and we want to choose the one that looks like a box plot. We're going to be tempted to hit the down arrow, but that will take us to X list. So in order to choose the box plot, we have to keep hitting the right arrow and hit it again. And this is the box plot with outliers that we want. We don't really want to choose this one because if there are outliers, we prefer to be able to see them. So let's hit enter to make sure this one is selected. And now it's blinking on the box plot with outliers. Now we can hit the down arrow. Our data is in L1, so that's fine. Frequency is always 1. And the mark, you can just leave it. It's not that important. And now to get a good window, we're going to go to zoom along the top. Zoom. And if we go down, we'll see that number 9 is zoom stat. And for our stat graph here, that'll give us a nice window. So we'll hit enter or 9. And there's our box plot. And you'll notice there's this other function that's appearing here. If we don't like that, we can clear it here. And then go back to graph. Okay, so we can see that our data set's slightly right skewed. And let's look at our data set again and find Q1, the median, and Q3. There's 6 points, so it's an even data set. So go ahead and identify Q1, the median, and Q3 for this data set. Okay, so because it's an even data set, the median is going to be the average of these two middle numbers. So the median should be 4.5. That leaves 3 numbers in the lower half of the data set and 3 numbers in the upper half. So our Q1 then will be 3, and our Q3 will be 8. So here we can hit trace along the top, and we'll see our 5-number summary. So our min is 2, hit the right arrow. Q1 is 3, which is what we expected. Median, 4.5. Q3, 8. Hit the right arrow again. Max is 12. Now let's add a data point to our set here and see what happens. So let's go back to Stat Edit and add the number 30. And now we want to redraw the box plot. So we can go to second y equals, hit enter. You can see that everything is selected. It's on, we have the right box plot selected, our data is still in L1. So this is fine. So now we can go back to zoom and choose number 9, zoom 9. And there's our revised box plot. So here we have this odd data set. So go ahead and identify Q1, the median, and Q3. So because this is an odd data set, there is a middle number, which in this case is 5, so this is the median. That still leaves 3 numbers in the lower half and in the upper half of the data set. So Q1 will be 3. And Q3 will be 12. So here let's hit trace, and we'll see that the min is 2, hit the right arrow. We have a Q1 of 3, a median of 5, a Q3 of 12. which happens to also be the highest value in our data set that's not an outlier. So you can see there's no extra whisker here because Q3 is the highest value that's not an outlier. And now we have our outlier denoted separately at 30. Okay, so that's how you make a box plot. Invariably, what will happen is at some point, you'll be trying to make some other kind of graph and you'll get some error or your window will be off. So it's good to know how to turn these plots off. So we can go to second y equals. And if we want to turn all of them off, we can choose number 4. Number 4 would turn all our plots off. If we just want to turn one of them off, for example, this one, we could hit enter and then toggle it to off. And now it's off. So what happens is sometimes if you have 2 or 3 of these plots on, they might interfere with each other, and then you won't get an appropriate window and you'll get an error message. So whenever you get an error message when you're trying to make stat plots, make sure only the plots you want on are on. Similarly, if you're trying to make a y equals graph, you might as well go and turn all your plots off if you only want to look at your y equals graphs. That's it for this video. If you liked it, click thumbs up and subscribe below. Thanks for watching.